Hey guys, it's Chris. From animals that can easily adapt to pretty much any conditions to ones that have altered their bodies to survive in any weather, here are 10 animals with bizarre adaptations. Number 10, Plethodontidae. One of the most basic things that animals need to survive is oxygen, and most creatures have lungs to do just that. But for the family of salamanders known as Plethodontidae, they don't have that option, because they don't have lungs. These unique salamanders breathe directly through their skin and the tissues that line their mouths. You might think that such a unique species of salamander would be small in terms of number, but this family actually makes up the largest among all salamanders. Pretty cool, huh? One of the most unique of this family is the ET salamander, a member that was found in Ecuador back in 2009. It was named after the creature from the Spielberg film due to its oddly shaped head. Despite it being found in 2009, there's still not much known about the creature, but expeditions are being done to learn more. Number 9. Okapi. The Okapi were first discovered by European travelers in the 20th century, and when they saw them, they thought it had to be the unicorn of legend, mainly because they thought it had one horn when actually it has two. Well, close enough. Despite the Okapi not being out in the open too often, scientists were able to study them, and through the studies, they were found to have a very special tongue of all things. This tongue of the Okapi is actually over a foot long, and just as bizarre, it's not shaped like a regular tongue either. Actually, it's shaped like a tube. This allows the Okapi to grasp onto leaves from high trees and then bring them down. It also has the length to be able to lick and clean its own eyeball. Gross. And in case you were curious, the closest relative to the Okapi isn't a horse or a zebra, it's actually a giraffe. Number 8. Manned wolf. At first glance, the manned wolf from South America may appear to be a wolf, or even a red fox, or an interesting hybrid maybe between those two species, but in fact it's not. Instead, the manned wolf is a unique member of the CANID family, which does indeed include wolves and foxes. But the creature is not related to them in full. They're their own creatures, which, let's be honest, already makes them kind of special. But what truly makes them unique compared to other members of their family is their legs. As you can see, the legs are much longer than most foxes and wolves out in the wild. But the reasoning for these legs is a bit unclear in the eyes of scientists. The more prevailing theory is that because the manned wolves live in South America, the creatures need to deal with all the tall grass and vegetation in the area. Thus, through its longer legs, it's able to keep its head above the grass and able to ensure that it can hear predators and prey around it. This is definitely a family trait because wolves and foxes are also very alert creatures by nature. Its ears have also been adapted to ensure that all sounds reach them, including the subtle scurrying of rats, which are part of its meal most times. Number 7. Wood frogs. When winter comes, animals on land adapt to the situation in their own unique ways. But for the wood frog, it's another matter. They don't run or hide or burrow themselves into the ground or a tree. Instead, the wood frog just freezes over where it stands. I do mean this in the literal sense, too. Their insides will freeze through the water that's just naturally inside them. This new state that it finds itself in is so deceiving that if you were ever to go and find a wood frog after they've frozen over, you'd think they were dead. As they don't try and run when you get close, they won't have a pulse, and you can pick them up and basically do anything to them as long as they're still frozen. Which begs the question, how do they get out of this state? And the answer is temperature. When it's warm enough to melt them, they return to their regular living state, to the extent that they can be up and hopping around in a matter of minutes, despite being frozen for several weeks or months depending on their location. And then when winter comes once again, they freeze up and just repeat the cycle. Number 6. Kangaroo rat. The kangaroo rat is a small creature that likes to live in the western parts of North America. Yet they're called this because they have big legs that are bipedal, and thus allow them to hop around like a kangaroo. So, thus, kangaroo rat. As for their true adaptations, though, they have the ability to survive without drinking a single drop of water. This adaption came to be because they like to live in desert areas. And as you know, a desert can be notorious for only having certain amounts of water to go around. Thus, the kangaroo rat developed a way to engage in desert travel without really having to search for water for itself. That being said, that doesn't mean that the kangaroo rat doesn't need moisture, as that is actually a vital thing for life to survive, including for this creature. What they do to compensate is that they get water from a place that isn't typical. They get it from seeds. The kangaroo rat also likes to eat seeds, and its body has become able to extract all the moisture from these seeds. Now you might think, seeds are tiny, so how much moisture can actually get in there? But they actually don't need a lot. They just need enough to survive until their next water source. Number 5. Gironook. The Gironook is a type of antelope, and just like most antelope, they live on the African plain. However, they don't eat the same way as its species does, or as any other creature on the plain like gazelles do. While antelope and gazelles are good on land in regards to running and jumping, they cannot reach the trees. So the Gironook evolved and gave themselves longer necks and skinny legs. What this rather unique evolution does is allow the Gironook to stand on its back legs to prop itself up against a tree, and then use its neck in order to reach for the food it wants to get. If you're curious as to why a creature would feel the need to have this adaption, well, it's because on the African plain, there's a lot of competition. For example, there are 91 species of gazelle that live in Africa, and during dry seasons, it's a bit tough to feed all the mouths. But because the Gironook is the only one of these particular animals that can reach trees, it means that they're able to get their food without much worry. As in all things, though, there is a catch to this adaption. Because the legs of the Gironook are so skinny, the bones inside them are extremely fragile. And thus, if they stay on their hind legs too much, their legs will actually break. In fact, there have been many cases of this happening to Gironook. Still, despite this, though, it's a useful advantage to have in a place with a lot of other animals. Number 4. Notothenioidei. Have you ever wondered how fish in the Antarctic actually survive? I know I have. The waters around the area are incredibly cold, and thus you need to have some keen adaptions to survive in them. For the suborder known as Notothenioidei, they have a very simple way of combating the cold. Mainly, they have antifreeze in their veins. And this isn't a joke exactly. No, they don't have the antifreeze you put in your vehicle to keep it from freezing up, but they do have proteins within their system that actually do a very similar thing. These proteins will actively find ice crystals that make it into the fish's blood and then bind to them so they can't freeze their insides. So the fish, they can swim within these cold waters without fear of ever getting frozen over. So powerful is this adaption that 90% of the fish that live in the Antarctic waters are from the suborder Notothenioidei. Number 3. Irrawaddy. Dolphins as a species have been known to be very kind to humans, even saving their lives in certain circumstances. However, a more commercial use for getting help from dolphins has been found in the dolphin species known as the Irrawaddy. The Irrawaddy primarily live in the waters of Southeast Asia, such as the Bay of Bengal, and for many years they observed the local fishermen capture fish. One day, they adapted their behavior to actually help them catch fish in exchange for some fish for themselves, which means you could define this adaption as you scratch my back, I'll scratch yours. The dolphins will actually lure in the fish, and then the fishermen release their nets and bring them in. The Irrawaddy are rewarded with fish before the nets are brought in for the fishermen. Believe it or not, no other animal in the world has adapted so that they can benefit off of human behavior in this way, which is actually rather astonishing, especially given how long humans and animals have been around one another. This new relationship has been so profitable for certain fishermen that there are actually battles to get the best Irrawaddy and make sure they're not stolen by others. Number 2. Greater Shorthorned Lizard. The greater short-horned lizard is a predator itself, and is a patient one at that. But when predators come its way, it has an adaptation that scares them off pretty quick. This lizard has a way of exerting pressure within its body to actually build up packets of blood. Then, when the predator is close enough, it'll actually squirt the blood it stored up at the predator in question, and it'll squirt it from its eye. This defensive tactic is useful for two reasons. One, the sudden action of squirting blood from their eyes is likely very off-putting, and will make the predator think that there's maybe something very wrong with the lizard. The other reason for this being a deterrent is that the blood itself is very potent in terms of taste. If the lizard is able to project the blood into the foe's mouth, they'll get a taste most foul. So between the sight and the taste, predators will want to have nothing to do with them. Now, this may sound disgusting, but in the animal kingdom, you need to use whatever is at your disposal in order to stay alive, and that's what the greater short-horned lizard does. Number 1. Sunda flying lemur. The best way to think about the Sunda flying lemur is by comparing it to an animal with a similar trick, the flying squirrel. However, unlike flying squirrels, who have very furry extensions of their bodies rooted into their arms, the Sunda flying lemur actually has skin flaps that it uses to glide around. Very massive skin flaps. After it extends the flaps, the skin allows the flying lemur to cover an area that's actually 6 times the size of the lemur when its skin is all compressed. And yet the flap itself is thinner than a millimeter. In terms of its life, the Sunda flying lemur uses this skin to glide around the trees of Southeast Asia. And in fact, it only lives in the tall canopies of the trees in that area. It will never touch the ground willingly unless something drastic happens. The hands and feet of the Sunda flying lemur are adapted as well to being very useful for climbing. So it always has a way up or across depending on the need, further ensuring that it never reaches the ground. This creature is also one of only 2 known species of animal called Kalogo, and the other one is the Philippines flying lemur. Thanks for watching. What did you think of these bizarre adaptations? Let me know in the comments below. Be sure to subscribe before you leave, and then I'll see you next time on the channel.